Okay, let's do this fucking shit.
Hey, what's up? Welcome to Inept Pit, episode 32. Oh shit, I'm your host, Drew Campbell. The other fat guy is Evan Sasiela.
What is up?
Yeah, I don't know. What is up, Evan?
I don't know. We're back at it again.
Sure isn't your fake lord, I'll tell you that much.
Jeez.
I don't know. I don't know why you start like that. Or are you starting out on nasty terms? Yeah. I'm in a good mood. I shouldn't be doing that. I'm actually in a fantastic tit mood. Fantastic
mood. You being in a fantastic mood is opening the show with an atheistic comment?
Yes. I mean hating on your lord and savior means I'm doing fantastic today.
What's that shirt you're wearing?
It's a Stone Cold Steve Austin shirt. It says "Toughest SOB, Stone Cold." Which, by the way, probably a shirt you shouldn't wear to the bar. Like,
yeah,
it's asking for a fight. But if it's still, I mean, if I wear it to the bar, who cares? I wasn't at the bar earlier, but I've worn it at the bar before. It's like it's almost like you're asking someone to test it out.
Yeah, it sounds like I would fight.
You kind of,
if I wasn't such a wuss, I would be like, man, let's square up.
Yeah, and he's like, fuck it, this guy thinks he's tough. He looks like a bitch. What was he weigh 180 pounds, maybe, soaking wet? I could bench him.
Is that a small t-shirt?
This is, yeah, exactly. What is that, baby?
Yeah.
Is that baby-sized? I'm going to eat this guy for breakfast. Also, it just seems like kind of a douchebaggy shirt unless you realize it's a Stone Cold Steve Austin shirt. Then you're like, oh, that's a badass shirt.
Yeah, unless you don't watch wrestling like me.
Yeah, but I feel like there's a lot of people who don't watch wrestling that still know Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, definitely.
He was like the biggest star when wrestling was the biggest. So he's officially like the biggest wrestler of all time for wrestling. Because I guess The Rock would be the biggest wrestler of all time.
I was going to say, isn't The Rock?
But not during wrestling. The Rock was second fiddle to Stone Cold during that time period.
What about Hulk Hogan?
Hulk Hogan's up there. Definitely up there. But
not anymore, right?
No. After he said the N-word, he's out. He's out.
Yeah.
Yeah. Which is, I mean, honestly, good reason to not be famous. I mean, like, I'm not, like, a lot of people are like, cancel culture is too much. It's like, nah, and yeah, Hulk Hogan took it too far. Honestly, yeah, I think it's a
racial slur.
Aggressively, too. Yeah. It wasn't even a joke. I'm not saying that's okay, but fucking, it makes it not as bad as just, he said it out of hate. Like, he said it straight out of hate. I probably got canceled for saying just my beliefs on that subject. Jesus Christ.
Yeah, I guess.
Should probably change it. But Hulk Hogan's a racist piece of shit, but he has the most devastating leg drop of all time.
That's your defense?
Yes. he's a bald, he's like a horseshoe bald hot dog that can have a fucking atomic leg drop that'll apparently break your neck.
Yeah, I've never seen him wrestle.
And you're not missing much.
I never heard him have like a cool move or anything.
The atomic leg drop is finished. It's just a leg drop.
Oh.
Back in the day, wrestling wasn't as athletic. It was just these guys that were so massive and like doing so much steroids and such bodybuilders, they couldn't even move around. Like they were just so like physically limited in what they could do.
Would you say back in the old days, wrestling was based more on like personality and charisma over actual wrestling?
Yeah. I mean, that's all it was, but it still is based on that now. But well, it's just also people
talk to. Like, if I talk to you, you're usually referencing a bunch of moves.
Yeah, well, I mean, the athletic prowess draws you in, but characters are what make everything. Like, my favorite current guy is Jon Moxley, and he's probably not the most athletic guy out there, but he's good in the ring, and he has one of the best characters. He's basically me if I was just tougher.
Oh,
he looks like me. He walks like a badass.
He looks like you if you went to Planet Fitness every day.
Yeah, honestly, I look like a vegan version of him. Okay. I look like Jon Moxley if he didn't have a beard and was a vegan. Like, we have the same hairline and everything. Me and this guy are identical. We have the same swagger. I got the same swagger as him. I'm saying I'm as cool as Jon Moxley. I'm just not as strong. Hands down. Actually, pull up a video of him. Actually, we're going to pull up the video. No. Pull up the GCW video of him. That makes him so cool. This is he went to an indie event recently. Like normally he plays the bigger like cable shit, but he's so cool, he don't give a fuck. He'll go to these indie events and shit and attack people, which just makes him so much tighter than anybody. Like imagine that. That's like if fucking all right, it's like a good comparison for you. All right, that's like if Bono just showed up, like you were seeing a show at the Hamilton Street Pub in Saginaw, right?
Yeah.
And then fucking like these guys finished a song, and then Bono went up there and just jumped on vocals for a song. Isn't that
That's
kind of
insane.
cool? Wouldn't that be? Isn't that make him? Wouldn't that make Bono cooler? If he
It's
just did
also a
pop.
side note, today's Bono's birthday. Happy birthday, Bono. Gotta give a shout out
Why
to the
the
man.
fuck do you know that?
It's all over social media.
It is not.
I
It's all over
posted
your
about
social media. It's all over your social media.
it. I
It's not
posted
over my
about it.
social media. Well, of course you did. He is. Actually, to be honest, if you're like. All right, so a lot of people think that God, you could create your own image of him, right? Like, and he looks like whatever you want him to look like when you meet him. I've heard this. Have you seen this? Have you heard about this? Have you? Like, you kind of make your own idea.
Pretty
Do you
much.
think if God exists and you do go to the pearly gates of heaven, that you will be greeted at the pearly gates of heaven by Bono just going, hello, hello. Hola. Welcome to heaven. It's awesome here.
I feel like that'd be one of the first people I meet in heaven if I get there.
Or which I think no, honestly, I think your vision of God would be Bono.
If I was in heaven and I saw my family, I'd be like, I gotta say hi to Bono first.
Real quick, let me go
This is a
say
once
hi.
in
Let
a eternal lifetime moment.
me go say hi to the front man of YouTube. Nice to see you again, Grandma, but I've been kind of waiting on this longer than you. So I've met you before. I've never met Bono.
What am I pulling up here? J
John Moxley. John is with no H. And
Oh, maybe that was
GCW.
GCW. Okay.
Yeah.
Is it he confronts Nick Gage
Yes.
after his death match?
Yeah. So, I mean, now you're spoiling it. So,
No,
like
that's
he
the
says,
headline.
I already said yes. It's the only video of him in GCW. Stupid.
Okay. Should I play sound?
This is the check. No, you don't need to do that because,
Okay.
you
Now
know
it's
what?
too
Fuck it.
loud.
Fuck it. Do it. Fucking do it.
Checkers game where grandson
Share your
is.
screen, stupid.
There's an ad.
You still have to share the screen, stupid.
I know I gotta share the screen.
Do you, though?
Okay, here I go.
You still haven't shared the screen. That's the stupid part about this. The video's playing, but the screen isn't shared. How's that work?
Because I didn't share the screen yet. Now I'm
Is
sharing.
it's one button? How is it still? All right,
I'd say here we
fucking
go.
Jesus.
I'm
All right,
terrible.
full screen it. Full screen it. All
Play.
right. Yeah. Okay. So, all right. You know it's gonna be a good night when you see glass everywhere. Look, this guy's probably doing it for $30.
That looks dangerous.
Yeah, glass is dangerous. I mean, could you not tell by all the blood on his head? Like, and this guy's pouring blood on his head. I think that might be dangerous.
Could be pain or ketchup or something.
Why does your fucking internet suck so much?
Why?
This is clipping.
I'm fine.
You said that last time and the recording was not fine. You were a liar then and you're a liar now. Oh man. Look at this fucking nerd in the red shirt. That guy totally has never had sex with a lady. Most of these people have not. But, like, all right, look at him. He's like Jesus. He shows up. Everyone's like, my God, John Moxley, this is insane. This is pause it for a sec. Pause it for a sec. Pause it. All right. So, imagine I'm going to do a comedic thing for you. Imagine you're doing an open mic, right?
Yes.
And you're just sitting there, right? And then you just hear the crowd turn after you finish set, and they all start freaking out. You're like, what the fuck? What's going on there? And then the seats start to part, and just Bill Burr is walking up to the stage. What do you do in that moment, Evan?
I'd watch them and laugh, and then I'd cry that, oh, well, even if I had a good set, I'd be like, oh, no one cares because Bill Burr's there.
Yeah, you think that? I'd
Or
confront him, dude. I'd confront him.
you would confront
Yeah.
Bill Burr.
You have to say yes to the moment, man. I'm trying to become famous. What the fuck are you doing?
Get out
What
your
are you doing,
TikToks,
dude?
open my comedian.
I'm trying to make my moment in history. I'll make headlines if I do something crazy.
Well, if you fight him, like physically fight Bill
I
Burr.
wouldn't physically. I'd fight him with my words because that's what comedy is, stupid. Like, I'm not gonna just assault him and go to jail. That's what a lunatic
He
does.
probably would respect it. He'd be like, I like a guy who can
Yeah,
come up
because
and challenge me.
because I have balls. Even though he'd probably destroy me. Like,
Yeah.
not probably. He would.
It
He
would be
would. He
the
would.
Philly
Let's be
rant,
honest.
but just about you.
Yeah, exactly. But that's fine. If there could be a Drew rant from fucking Bill Burr, oh. Put me in the history books, doggy. All right, hit play. Right. So that's what just happened. Bill Burr's confronting. But look at him. All right. Cool as fuck, right? I need to get that haircut. That's a good haircut for a bad hairline.
You need to grow a beard.
Yeah, that's true.
Holy shit. Is that what they're chanting? Holy shit.
Yeah, the crowd chanting. We chant. If you go to wrestling shows, there's a lot of swearing at some of them. It's fun. Also, if you've never yelled "Holy shit" with a group of people, you haven't lived life yet fully. There's something super important about "Holy shit, holy shit." It's fun.
That
It's a lot
actually
of
is
fun.
pretty sweet.
Wrestling is big, stupid fun. You can just mute the audio. Audio is shit. Look, it's barbed wire and broken 2x4s. It looks like me drunk trying to get into my house. Has come through the drywall like the Kool-Aid man.
Chairs everywhere. There's bottles.
Yeah, I mean, like, go back to look how he just walks. He carries himself with such big dick energy. That's why I walk like that. I've been told I have big dick energy. I'm not gonna back it up. Hey, all right. Just kidding. I got my dick's not even the size of a pinky.
Oh.
See, look at that. Look at just how he walks. He's got swagger. This is what if, Evan, you need to start walking like that. You'll be able to get a girl if you walk like
Oh
that.
my
Also, you need a leather jacket.
God. As you
Leather
said,
jacket.
I look like Snorlax. That's not a good walk. It's
You
just like
let no, I want it.
waddling.
No,
I'm
it's
just
good. No,
waddling.
don't waddle. You get the leather jacket. First off, that's a good way to get herpes. There's so much blood on his
As you
head,
said,
and
I
you
would
watch
never
that.
do this ever if I just saw a guy with blood and just on his forehead. I would never do
Evan. You couldn't climb up the three steps to get into the ring.
I would be
You would
that.
never
Yeah,
even
I'm
do it.
tapping
Now,
out.
how many steps? Oh, no way, no way. Look, he's got his blood all over his head. I feel like people say that with a different head when they're doing anal sex for the first time. I got your blood all over my head. Am I right, Evan? Am I right? Did you know what I'm
Yeah,
saying?
yes,
Okay,
yeah.
all
No,
right.
no.
Look, the crowd's loving it, losing their shit.
That's one of the favorite parts of wrestling is just seeing the crowd. Like the first three rows just loving it.
Losing their mind. Dude, I
Exactly.
need to go to one of these events so I could fuck people up like that. I'd fucking be excited as hell. Oh, wait, is he leaving? Oh, no. No, he starts flicking him off. You don't flick off fucking me, dude. You flick me off, get ready to fight. Ready to fucking, I'm gonna do some stupid wrestling moves. We've already talked about this. If I get in a wrestling mat or if I get in a fight at the bar, I'm gonna do the move that's about to happen. You know, I mean, this is what I'm gonna do. I'm just immediate. That's my first move. Kill a guy. Kill a guy just right in the concrete.
Love the guy in the front row with this camera, just like I'm recording history right here.
Yeah. This guy's like, I had no idea this is gonna happen. Look at that walk.
Oh.
I love when you get into it. It makes me so happy. It's like when I was a kid, the first time I was watching wrestling. And that's right here. That's what I do.
I love
Wait.
wrestling. I love wrestling where it's not a wrestling movie, just punch them in the face.
Yeah, and then just hit glass. Wait, now this is where it gets crazy. So those are light tubes. Just broke it. All right. Set them up on the ground. It's a bad time for it to be clipping. God, this made our podcast. There we go. And oh. Why he's got so much blood on his fucking head, though.
Yeah, that's too much.
And then look how he's walking. It's like you kind of have to walk like you're taking a shit, but you also have to walk like you have a huge dick. Does that make sense?
No,
That's
it
how you
totally
need to
makes
start
sense.
walking.
That's a perfect description of that strut.
Yeah, that's how you need to walk. I walk like that.
Yeah, it's not my thing.
You need to try it.
I
Why
have
would
tried.
it?
It's not my thing.
You can cut the video. You can cut the video. You've never tried that walk. Why did you just blatantly lie? As a Christian man, you lie way too often.
No,
Yeah, you
I don't
did. Why
try
did
that
you
one.
say? You said you tried that walk. You never did.
Not in front of
You just
you.
made that completely up. You never tried that. Confront
Well,
your lies right now. We're talking to Jesus. Jesus, are you listening right now? Oh, you're always around. That's right. Why is your disciple lying to me?
I'm not one of the 12.
You're not an apostle. I said you are a disciple.
They
Stupid.
were, it's like the same thing. It's like the synonym.
No,
The disciples of Jesus.
Look it
The 12
up.
disciples.
Look it up,
Now
dummy.
we're going from wrestling to Christianity.
We always bring up Christianity because I got a rip on you for it. Look up disciple. The disciples are followers. Apostles. Now those are different. We're all disciples if we follow them. I'm almost 100% certain on that.
I typed in disciples in Christ and the same.
No, you don't even have
page.
To. You don't have to do disciples in Christ. Don't you need to Google? Look up the definition of the word disciple. It is a word. Get the Webster definition of it. And share it. Share the page before you read it. Don't read ahead of time. We're reading it together so you can feel stupid. So you can feel real dumb. I don't All like right. it when you think you know things. Okay, disciple. A personal follower of Jesus during his life, especially one of the... Fuck! Oh, wait, no. Down here. A follower, student of a teacher, leader, or philosopher. You are a follower of your teacher, Jesus, so you are still a disciple. I'm still correct. I'm still saying I'm correct.
Nay, I guess you are, then.
Technically speaking, from the form of a disciple, I am correct. So, Jesus, why is your disciple forsaken you? First, he denied you. You're going to deny him three times before the day's over?
I thought you were just going to quote the lyrics, the chop suey by System of a Down. the bridge.
Yeah. Fuck, I've been listening to System of a Down recently. They fucking kick ass.
I wouldn't expect that take from you.
Really? Why?
They just seem like a band that you would like in like high school or something that you would just grow tired of.
Well, I liked it when I was actually a kid, and then I fell out of it. But now I've been like growing up as a person, and I don't hate. I pretty much like all music. I mean, really, like I said, I mean, even till this day, I think I can get into any song, except for pop punk. Like that's the only stuff I couldn't. I just can't.
You can
I haven't
to
found
country.
Yeah, modern country's Gospel. Rough. Modern country's rough. I can do the old school country. You've talked about this before.
Gospel.
Glenn Campbell fucking rips, dude. Southern Nights. Gospel? Some of those go in, dude. Technically, Johnny Cash did gospel.
Yeah.
I mean, Ring of Fire and When the Man Comes Around are both gospel songs by technicality. So, yes, I fucks with the gospel.
Your only gospel artist is Johnny Cash.
Yeah, and it is. Now, there's another really good one. Look at top gospel artists. There's someone else I'm forgetting.
I think
I want to say it was a black
Josh Groban's one. I think
that's not what I was going with. It is a black woman with a fantastic voice. So I'm trying to think of, but I don't know her name off the top of my head. Oops, that doesn't make me look good. Oops, a daisies.
That's your description.
At least I knew it. Most of these people never even knew that they don't even know about her. So if anything, I'm still a step in the right direction.
You got Kirk Franklin, Marvin Sapp.
I feel like these are all modern people, though, because Johnny Cage isn't even up there. Look up. Yeah, see, for the year. Look up. Well, technically, Kanye West is gospel now, so yeah, fucks with gospel. I forgot about that. I forgot he went full Christian, didn't you?
Yeah.
Look up of all time.
Yeah, there's Kanye.
Look up all time.
Why?
Oh, wait, maybe this is where I was looking for. Aretha Franklin. That's who I was thinking of. Aretha Franklin kicks ass. Why couldn't I think of her name?
Elvis, too.
Yeah, technically, yeah. Badass, so. Yeah, I fucks with gospel.
Yeah.
So, I mean, I knew more gospel artists than you did. You didn't even
you
know one.
Said Kanye.
You didn't even know one. I could get down with some Christian rock.
I said
too,
Josh Groban. Okay.
No, I said Christian rock, not gospel. There's a difference, stupid.
Learned yeah, mercy.
Christian
mercy.
Rock? No. I was going to say Creed. I listen to Creed.
Arms wide open.
With all my whole hair. Hell, 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 h I'm gonna
No,
do karaoke
I
of
feel
that
bad for
song.
that band. That impression, that exact impression has been done for that band for 20 years.
What are you talking about? Impression? That's just what they sound like. I was just singing Creed. I wasn't doing anything wrong. I'm gonna
They kind of
fucking
sound like
do.
Nickelback.
That's my new thing. Well, everyone was like Creed, Nickelback. They were all trying to sound like Eddie Vedder, but they took it too far.
Three
Eddie
Doors
Vedder of
Down.
Pearl Jam. Yeah, they're all just trying to sound like fucking.
Yeah.
The Three Doors Down did have a good song. They had that Kryptonite song. I loved that as a kid. That went in as a kid. You don't call me crazy. I'll tell y'all Superman.
Superman.
Everyone knows that song.
That's a
Look,
great
look.
song.
And I remember the music video was that old dude dressed up like Superman trying to save the young girl. I remember I got a boner to that music video. Play the music video for that. I got a boner to that. There's a hot girl in it. I remember that's like one of, that's an early Drew boner. I remember that. Y'all want to share this experience? Watch this music video. That was like I was like I remember watching that music video. I'm like, I like ladies. Like, find out I like ladies.
God, this is 328 million views. I'm pulling this up right now.
Holy shit, dude, crushing it. It's Three Doors Down, murdered it.
There's an ad.
Well, I don't want to watch the ad.
I'm skipping it.
Crisp, I don't even know what that is. See? Look at that. I already know the music of the old guy. Fucking
That's
play the
me. That's
music.
me, and like, you can't play the music.
All right, fair enough. Giving them the doors, dude. Not the good doors. The doors are sick. Three Doors Down, not so much. Three Doors Down is a good name for a band, though, right? Can we agree on that?
Oh, it's a fantastic name.
It's a
It's
fantastic
a
name. Like
fantastic name for like a 2000 band like this.
oh yeah, it sounds awesome.
Knocked it out of the park.
I mean, it's crazy. It's like any of those like half sentence bands kind of kick ass. Like, what's another one? Well, some of them are metal. That was like later 2000s. Like Every Time I Die. It's a great name for a band.
Oh,
I'm
yeah.
not a fan. I'm not really a fan of that band, but that's a fucking great name of a band. What would the name of our band be?
In that pit.
No, that's enough pizza.
Put down the slice. That's a good album
Yeah.
name. Put down the slice.
Yeah,
One
let's see.
last slice is like the last album. That's great.
One Last Slice is a fucking no. One Last Slice is a really good fucking band name, Evan.
Well,
That's
I've
a
heard of the band name
fucking
then.
sick band name. Also transitioning, I think I just joined a band.
Yeah, I believe you brought that
Yeah.
up. And I, yeah.
Yeah. You want okay, you know, hold up on the crypto. Should I tell this whole story
I
first?
guess so.
Okay.
Now that
All
we're on
right.
it.
Okay, so Friday, I told you on the last cast, well, I was gonna take shrooms and go see Mortal Kombat, right?
Yes.
So I did take shrooms and go see Mortal Kombat. And holy fuck. Okay, look, there's a lot of people who are just talking all kinds of shit of Mortal Kombat. Bring up what's the Rotten Tomato score for you don't have to show the screen, just tell me what the Rotten Tomato score is for Mortal Kombat. Because I've heard a lot of people saying, fuck this movie, bad movie, it's terrible, it's awful in every way, blah, 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 blah. First off, which my defense is when people have told me it was awful, like I heard it was bad. It's like, yeah, it's a martial arts movie. It's gonna be bad, but it's gonna be awesome martial arts. That's what martial arts movies are. You think Bruce Lee movies were good? Nah, this is Bruce Lee did some cool ass martial arts in them. That's why you watched them.
Tomato meters at 54 and the audience score is 86.
So it's not even that bad. I thought it was lower than that. 54 is not that bad. I mean, it's bad, but it's not
It's
great.
not like
That's
30.
not, I mean, it's not, it's bad, but it's not like the worst. It's not like a seven.
Yeah.
It's not like the newest Hellboy that came out. That was like a seven, and I went and saw that. Weren't wrong. It was a pretty bad movie. But so a lot of people were, I had a lot of people talk shit about Mortal Kombat, and I was just like, I went and saw it on shrooms, of course. This might change it, but greatest movie I think I've ever seen in my entire life. I think it's the greatest movie I've ever seen. You know, I laughed, I cried, I shit my pants. It was a whole experience. It was a roller coaster of emotions. What?
And so, is that true?
Yeah, no, I shit my pants. I can tell you, Liu Kang summons a fucking fire dragon like he used to do in his old goddamn fatalities. And I shit my pants, dude. I couldn't handle it. It was just amazing. I shit my pants out of pure excitement.
The theater was a
of amazement. Oh, that theater hate me. I was laughing at everything throughout the way. Every time someone got brutally killed, I was cackling. Dude, no, cackling. And there's supposed to be lines that are funny in the movie, and I probably laughed at those way too hard. Like I would laugh, and then I would be still laughing as the scene continued at the last thing.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
If you just walked in the theater, I wonder if people are like, man, that guy's on
that guy. No, they probably just think that guy sucks. It's like, that guy sucks. Because I was just laughing. It wasn't like I fucking pulled my pants down and did like a disco dance with my balls or something like that. It's not like I did something. I just overly laughed and cackled. They probably thought I was a huge nerd and I was just geeking out about Mortal Kombat and was just loved it way too much. Like, Jesus, man, it's not that good of a movie. Calm down. Yeah. It's the greatest movie I've ever seen. Like, oh, you need to go see Mortal Kombat. If you haven't seen Mortal Kombat, go see it. And if you haven't seen it, go see it on Shrooms. You should definitely see Mortal Kombat on Shrooms. It is wonderful. I've never seen a better movie. Like, ever. It was everything I ever wanted out of a movie, and now it's my favorite movie of all time. I haven't watched it sober yet, so
I'm going to say
you might I don't think I ever will. I don't think I ever will. I think I will. I want to keep this memory of how amazing it was like that. So if I ever watch it again, I think I just got to do Shrooms again before I watch it.
You're going to watch the Benchwarmers on Shrooms. You'll be like, funniest comedy movie ever.
Yeah, exactly. This is the best movie ever. Pick your Shroom movie. Whatever you want to be your favorite movie of all time. Just you be the first movie you ever watched while taking Shrooms. And well, it has to be in theaters, though. The theaters make it better. It's the atmosphere. You're locked in the screen.
The atmosphere. Oh, you're annoying everyone who has to pay $20 to be in that theater.
Fuck them. I was laughing. Who hates laughter? You know who do? The Nazis. The Nazis hated laughter. That's why they never took a break. So what, if you hate laughter, thank you. Congratulations for supporting Hitler. Actually, speaking of which, so after that, we were supposed to go out to dinner. I was with my brother, and we were meeting his girlfriend, and we went to Frankenmuth. And I was like, I walked around downstairs for a while. Like I had to go to the bathroom. They were trying to find the restaurant. So I went downstairs in the Bavarian Inn where they have all those shops, dude. And I was just cackling at everything because everything was hilarious to me. Like I was walking around a candy shop and I'm like, ah, fuck, this is like Willy Wonka on the chocolate factory, dude. Like, I want to fall into a vat of chocolate. I want to fall into a river of chocolate right now. I just stopped and bought candy for them, even though I didn't know if they wanted them. Like, I love them. I'm going to buy them those chocolate covered Oreos because that's what a good person would do. And then I fucking was walking around this antique point and I saw this bird, this porcelain bird. And I just stared at that bird for like 3 minutes. I was just laughing. It looked like a happy bird, right? If that makes sense. And I was just like, I feel you, bird. Me and you are here right now.
I feel like you're sweeter on drugs.
I know.
Doing good deeds. You're like, let me just buy this.
I am. This fucking porcelain bird. I should have bought it. But I was wearing my mask, so I feel like I didn't look as like much of a psychopath because I was just walking around going, And then I heard this older woman go up to another woman and she goes, we gotta leave. Mom's hips bothering you. And I was like, well, your mom's hips bothering me. I gotta leave. Like, it's killed my whole energy. Loud? Yeah, I did.
Are you serious?
Yeah.
To them? Do they hear you? Do they say anything?
They looked at me and I walked away. I went back upstairs and I found them sitting at the place and they're like, we're like eating. I'm like, I don't know. For some reason, I can't do food right now. Does that make sense? Food seems weird. I'll do a beer though. And then we drank there and we went back. They drove me. Like, I didn't drive for any of this. God bless me. God bless them.
God bless them.
So I went back. They drove me back and we were going to go to the bar. And then I bought, I ate more shrooms when I got back to the bar because they were in my car. And then I went to bar. I danced for a while on bar. I was ridiculous. But then my buddy Vince was there. And I was talking about, I just saw Mortal Kombat. We were outside. And I said, I wanted to like do some martial arts with like weapons and shit. And he's like, I got nunchucks on me right now. I'm like, bullshit. No, he's like, I got retractable metal nunchucks on me right now. I'm like, let me see him. I don't believe you. And he pulled them out. I'm like, get the fuck out of here. So I grabbed him, dude. And I was just playing with nunchucks out in front of the bar. I was blessed. It was the best. You ever play with nunchucks after you see Mortal Kombat? You're a true fucking. I did the fucking tuck, dude. You like, blah, 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 and then you bring it back and tuck it. And I was just swinging it. He had to take him away from me. After a while, he realized, he let me play with him for a while. He realized, yeah, this is getting dangerous. I need to get those away from him. Because I was just going into it. I would not sound like, I dare a motherfucker come at this bar, dude. I'll fuck him up. I'll fuck up. I got some nunchucks, dude. I'm about to beat someone's ass. They took him away, and I was there for a little bit, and I was like, all right, I'm going to wander down the street. And I wandered into this, I wandered down the street, went to another bar where there's this, these two guys playing like guitar. They're playing like a set, and I listened to it. I was like, oh, that's fucking good. And then they get down, done with their set, and the lead singer was like having a beer, and I walk up to him, and I was like, hey, man, it was a really good set. And he goes, yeah, thanks, man. He goes, hey, you play drums, by the way, right? And I was like, in that moment, I'm like, how does he know I play drums? What the fuck is going on right now? Like, what is happening? And he just goes, yeah, man, we're looking for a drummer for our band. Would you like to like play with us sometime? And I'm like, oh, I've been looking to play with a the universe has brought this band to me. Yes. And so now I'm in a band.
It's awesome.
Congrats. Yeah, it's called Great White Rhino. Follow us Great on Bandcamp. Follow us on Bandcamp.
That will overtake this podcast. And that pit will die.
No, dude. I'm like, first off, I'm killing life right now. At least I'm cool. I got shows coming up. I got a bunch of shows this week.
I saw your tour.
Saying it's a tour is a lot.
Open mic tour.
I'm doing mics, doggy. Yeah. But I got a bunch of shows. Well, people have been asking me when my shows are, so I just was like, fuck it. Also, then other people can see I have work ethic. At least other comics.
I was going to say, I'm like, damn.
That's how you do it.
Someone's hustling. You're going to Traverse City?
Yeah, I'm in Traverse City tomorrow night. I'll be like, doing Traverse City before this.
Before the podcast.
Yeah, before ours. But I'll plug the rest of my shows at the end. But yeah, fucking Great White Rhino, dude. I just came from band practice. Drums. Check us out on Bandcamp. Like, watch I'm saying all this. I did one practice and the next practice. Like, it's not really working out. Like, I got band practice on Wednesday. I feel like a kid again, dude. I'm like, I'm a band practice. It's like, do we have to also, like, should we also smoke weed and hide it from our mom while we're doing this? Like, that's what band practice was for me.
I hope you blow up with you as a drummer, because just going, doing interviews or podcasts or anything, that's a great story of how you got into a band.
Yeah, I know, right?
I went from throwing nunchucks on mushrooms outside of a bar to being the drummer of Great White Rhino. And like,
Great White Rhino. Well, dude, I hope you realize, though, if anything gets signed from this band, we have to delete every episode of the show.
We'll set it to private.
Yeah, exactly. It's I'm not trying to get Shane Gillis'd, you know?
Canceled?
Yeah. But, I mean, as long as we get ahead of it, you know? I'll have to go clean up my Twitter. Whew, there's some bad stuff on there from the past.
Like high school 2013.
Yeah.
Well, you can make a defense for high school.
I still don't think it's gonna work.
No,
I'll still
depends on how bad it is.
I don't know. I said a lot of fucked up shit back then, all for laughs, but that doesn't matter. It doesn't, context doesn't matter. So, woo. Gotta go clear up that Twitter, boy. That's why I don't plug it.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But,
lyrics of Three Doors Down, Kryptonite.
I totally forgot. Here we go. We are starting the share here. And here we go.
Well, I took a walk around where ease my trouble. I don't know if I'm doing that right. I don't remember how the song starts. I left my body lying somewhere in the sands of time. It's really just why I know, because it was, if I go crazy, then will you still call me Superman?
No,
if
I won't.
I'm alive and well. Dude, if I could fly, I don't know. It'd just be cool.
I was going to say, I don't know what you could do.
It would just be cool. It'd be fucking cool to fly. If it was fly, dude, I would never buy fried chicken again, and I would just fly and open my mouth and eat birds. I'd go at them at the same speed and just fucking swallow birds whole. It would do that cartoony thing where you see them go right down into my stomach, and then my stomach bulges out with like a little bird thing, and then it rumbles down, and then you hear the gurgle gurgle as they're devoured in acid.
I feel like you'd be attacked by birds if you flew.
Oh, dude, you think I can't fuck up birds? I'll fuck
In
a
the
bird up.
midair, if you're just
What kind of
fucking
bird?
there.
I also can fly, so I'm at the same advantage as them. It's the same for both of us. It's not like I'm a fish out of water. I can fly now,
They have
so it's.
beaks and stuff.
I have fists, dude. You know, strong
Yeah, but
compared to him.
you'll be outmanned.
I just saw Mortal Kombat, dude. I'll be breaking fucking necks, dude. You can just twist those things. Birds have very delicate necks. You could fuck a bird's neck up.
You'll be outmanned. They're always in flocks.
So there's me, dude. I'll just be like, I'll fucking just like multi, just fucking break them. I'll fly into the flock doing a fucking Liu Kang bicycle kick and just breaking all their necks. It's fucking neck kick, neck kick, neck kick.
I'm imagining this like in a busy city. So people look up, you're like, that guy's fighting
It's
birds up
just,
there.
is that dude bicycle kicking birds? Like, oh, doing the fucking Liu Kang bicycle kick. Hell yeah. I want to learn that move. I want to do a bicycle kick in my life. Do you know what a bicycle kick is?
No.
Okay, so a bicycle kick is when you run, like look at my fingers, jump off the air, and then while in the air, kick, 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 and then land back on your feet.
That
Do like eight of
sounds.
them. Except he does it super fast. So it's like, ah, it's like it's so cool. Liu Kang's dope. He's a fucking badass. All right. We're done with the lyrics. We don't need them anymore.
We read through one lyric.
I'm so hyped on Mortal Kombat. If you were a Mortal Kombat character, which one would you choose? Like for powers only.
I gotta think about that one.
Because you never played Mortal Kombat because you're a bitch.
Pretty much,
Your
yeah.
mom wouldn't let you play Mortal Kombat because it was rated M. Pussy. Mortal Kombat is one of my. There's my two favorite video game franchises of all time are Resident Evil and Mortal Kombat. And they just dropped a new Resident Evil. I need to go buy that and play it. I like things that are spooky, and I like things that are fighty.
I'd be sub-zero.
You just picked the first one you saw, didn't you?
That's the third one.
Why? Did you see his powers?
I was trying to set you up for a loser comment. Sub-zero.
Oh, yeah. I mean, I'll whoop your ass. I don't know. What the fuck you mean, loser? How are you setting me up for anything? Sub-Zero is such a basic bitch answer, but it would be cool to freeze shit.
That's what he does,
Right?
cool.
Oh, yeah. He has ice powers. Ice powers. This became really nerdy, this podcast. But ice power. If you could freeze something, what would you freeze? Look, if you had those powers, what would you use them for?
I don't know what I would do to freeze.
All right. First off, I already know what you'd do with it. You would just make your own snow cones all the time.
Not big. I'm laughing at the absurd that that is. That's such a great gift, and
This
I'm
is
making snow cones.
you,
It's
Evan.
like
You
a
would
little
grow
league.
it.
It's a little league concession stand.
So the second it happens, Evan, you've been granted the powers of Sub-Zero. Use them wisely. Fucking A, dude. Snow cone.
Who wants Sherry?
I
No,
picture you
I'm
now.
down there.
Yeah. I picture you now. You're gonna have a belt. You're gonna have like a bandolier belt of flavor of the sugar flavorings. So you could just keep making like snow cones all day, and then you're squirting different flavors out for yourself, whatever you feel like doing. What's your favorite snow cone flavor? Mine's green apple. What's yours?
I think it's cherry.
Cherry's pretty good, but green apple's best, especially if it's sour. I like me a sour green apple. What's your favorite like artificial flavors for candy in general? Because I think mine is it's different. I like green apple only if it's sour. Sour green apple kicks all the ass. And then my second one is blue raspberry, which I think is just raspberry. Like, why? There's no such thing as a.
It's
First
color.
off, I don't remember. I remember. I don't remember how old I was, but I know I was too old to figure out that blue raspberries aren't a thing. Like, I just didn't understand. They made it blue so they could still have a raspberry flavor, but it wouldn't take it away from the color palette of cherry. Right?
Yeah,
Because
it's just
blueberry flavor sucks. Like, blueberry would suck dick. You don't want a blueberry snow cone. But what's your favorite artificial flavor? And then so yeah, it goes fucking sour green apple. I'll do my top tier of flavors. Sour green apple, then blue raspberry, then cherry. Cherry's definitely up there. And depending on who's making it, like Airheads, the cherry's better in Airheads than the blue raspberry.
oh, I'm
But
crazy. I
most
haven't had an
times,
airhead in like
cherry.
a decade.
I know I kind of want fucking Airheads right now too. Shit, I'm kind of hungry. All I got in this fucking house are bagels and sausage though. That's all I have to eat.
All I
Is that a
had
weird combination?
for dinner, I just had tortilla chips and salsa from Tostitos.
Really? I didn't know they made those things in 5 gallon tubs.
Oh,
Get it? Because you eat a lot, and there's no way like a single thing could fill. You get it? You get it? You're fat. Do you understand that? You understand you're a big fat guy? That was the joke there.
yeah.
Okay, good.
Thanks for your reminder.
You're welcome. Yeah, sometimes you forget, and I just gotta bring it back down. I bring it back into reality. Fat zero.
That's my World Combat name. I'm in
No, 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 no. I
the
actually got this. He's sub zero, you're plus zero.
second place. Hey.
Plus zero over here. All right. What's your top three, though? What's your tier list? Artificial
I
flavors.
said cherry.
No, but your top three. Cherry's number one for you.
Yeah, and then blue raspberry.
Okay.
And third, I'm gonna have to say strawberry.
Did you say, wait,
Is
did you
that a
say
flavor?
strawberry or strawberry?
Strawberry.
Strawberry,
Strawberry.
it's a flavor for some stuff. I don't think it's a snow cone flavor. I figured you as a grape guy. You don't like grape?
Grape? No.
What's wrong with grape, Evan? What's wrong with grape?
Nothing
Huh?
wrong. I'm just not a
Huh?
fan of it.
You got very offensive about grape. Is it because it rhymes with rape?
No.
I think it makes it more fun of a flavor just because it's that close to being something terrible. But it's you add a G onto rape and now it's a delicious
What are
candy.
you saying?
I'm
This is such an extreme tangent that
just
I'm not sure
saying,
you go. I know, but
if you
I'm not
take
saying.
rape, right? You take rape, horrible, awful. Add a G to it, what a delicious candy flavor. I'm not gonna talk about the fruit, because grapes or whatever is a fruit flavor.
Yeah.
You give me grape juice? Ooh. Ooh, grape juice kicks ass. And grape flavor candies, like grape Airhead fucking rocks.
I like the.
Grape Laffy Taffy? Oh, very good. Grape Kool-Aid? Yummy, yummy. What do you like?
I like the watermelon Airheads, strawberry, cherry.
The watermelon Airheads? Fuck those. What the fuck is wrong with you? Who the fuck likes the watermelon? No,
Not
I mean,
bad.
I'll eat them when I buy a pack. I still eat the
Of
watermelon, but
course, I
it's.
eat all the Airheads. It's the one thing I'll
Well,
just eat
yeah. I
all.
don't, the orange is kind of rough.
Yeah, I agree.
Huh?
I
Yeah,
agree.
not an orange. I like orange flavor in some stuff, but for some reason, the flavoring for the Airheads of orange, not that good. There's something off about it. You know? I don't know what it is. Is it because orange doesn't rhyme with anything?
No, it's just, I think it's just, this is a terrible
Yeah, no, that
flavor.
you're right. That's a coincidence. That's a coincidence. That's
I
nothing to
think
do
it
with the
just
flavor.
doesn't taste good.
Orange is normal. Like orange juice is good. Orange pop, great.
Yeah.
I'm trying to think, is there any good orange candy though? Look up orange candies. What the fuck? All I can think of is that as an orange flavor is Airheads. Is there something I'm not thinking of? You know what candy sucks dick? Lemon heads. Who the fuck likes
Yeah,
those?
I agree.
Those and fucking hot tamales both blow ass.
That's such a weird thing. A strong stance for candy. Blow ass.
Yeah, those are the fucking ones that you'd get like those little dispensaries for a quarter. Oh my god, I can't even imagine that now. And you remember like, you know, like how they have those little dispensaries where you put the quarter in and then you twist it and you just leave it and it just dumps into your hand.
That's gone.
That's gone. Those are annihilated. Those are fucking. So someone walked. The fucking CDC walked into a place with that and just blew a shotgun into every one of those. kicked down the door to some fucking like small town Chinese restaurant. Bam! Is that what I think it is? Bam! Buckshot of fucking glass and hot tamales and lemon heads went everywhere.
Gonna see that in a museum now. Like, this is such a historical thing now.
Yeah. The fucking gumball machines, they fucking came in, they gave it a clothesline, then dropped an elbow drop on that fucking big dome, shattered it, and gumballs went everywhere. The staff tried to run after them and then slipped all over the gumballs. You damn kids, we're part of the CDC, we ain't no fucking kids. I have a doctorate.
They could also just remove it. I love how your idea of
I like them
DDC
destroying
is just
it.
a wrestling, like combat type of thing. Break the machines.
I also really like the idea of the employees slipping on the gumballs. That makes me happy inside. You know, the comedic, we're like, oh, whoa. And they're like fucking, they're still standing, but their feet keep like slipping. And then eventually they take the big old tumble. And then you hear a like one of those noises.
Now here's a
Everyone
good
feels me, right? My cartoon logic on this one.
A good orange candy. Starburst.
Yeah, but it's still one of the worst flavors you could draw. But I'll fucking rock with an orange, but still, like, cherry and strawberry are clearly superior. It's better than lemon. I don't know. Orange and lemon, they're right here. What's the flavors in the tropical Starburst? Because I actually think the tropical Starburst are better than the regular, because the tropical still has cherry, I'm pretty sure. No, it's the one that's all reds. If you can get the all red one, fuck. It's like strawberry, cherry. I think
there's mango, melon.
Well, that, no, I don't want that.
Strawberry, banana, cherry, kiwi, pina colada.
Oh, no, fuck the tropical. They sound like terrible. I'm thinking of something else. I'm thinking of tropical Skittles. Tropical Skittles kick ass. Tropical Skittles kick ass.
It's the same flavors.
Tropical Skittles go up. Tropical Starburst down. No, look up Tropical Skittles.
Taste
they're
the
way
rainbow.
More kick ass.
Banana berry, kiwi lime, mango something, pineapple, passion fruits, strawberry, star fruit.
Yeah. All sick. You know, it's not in there. Fucking pina colada.
Nope.
Who wants a coconut flavored? You know, speaking of which, fuck Almond Joys and Mounds. Get your coconut out of our chocolates. What the hell is that about?
Yeah.
It feels like eating like coconut. I don't mind the flavor of coconut, but eating coconut, it tastes like you're eating a bunch of fucking maggots. Feels like you're eating dead maggots.
That's such a. I can just see you start at the Facebook group, your campaign slogan. Get your coconuts out of our chocolates.
Get your coconuts out of our chocolate, you son of a bitch. That's the name of the page. It's just one long.
Yeah. Get your coconuts out of our chocolate, you son of a bitch. It's funny for some reason. It's such a weird thing to advocate for.
I'll fight it, dude. I'll protest. Hell no, we won't go. Get coconut out of... All right, wait, I got to work on the chant. The chant's not quite there yet. Chant's not quite there yet, but the message is. The message and the spirit behind it. That's where it's at.
Yeah.
So, you know, good for that. There's something you wanted to bring up, right?
Well,
we're flying through this. We got only 10 minutes left. Yes, it was Mother's Day. Yay. What'd you do for Mother's Day?
My mother came down. I actually gave her.
Your mother came to you?
Yeah, she came to Lansing.
Already, you're a bad son.
It's okay. I knew that already, was coming.
already a B-plus player at best.
Well, my sister was here.
So?
Also.
It sounds like you and your sister being a little selfish on Mother's Day.
Well.
Would you get your mom?
I paid for a sketch of us.
Oh, yeah, I saw that. That's fucking lame, dude. You're fucking pussy. What the hell is that about?
I thought it was nice.
I'm kidding. It was very sweet. You're a nice young, sweet man. And you're going to make a lady very happy one day once she gets past your terrible body and focuses on how good of a person you are. She's going to love you. But speaking of which, go ahead with your Mother's Day story.
They brought food to Lansing. They went to a barbecue place.
Oh, nice.
Ate it and enjoyed it.
Wow, you're so bad at telling stories. They brought barbecues. There you go. They brought barbecue food and we ate it and enjoyed it. It's like a 7-year-old's record. Yeah, today I was at school and there was hot dogs at the cafeteria and I ate it and I enjoyed it.
Then we watched the SNL rerun with Elon Musk.
Yeah, didn't he fuck up Dogecoin or whatever because of that? Didn't it plummet after he did that?
Yeah, a little bit.
Didn't he come out as having Asperger's?
It was a big monologue, yep.
Hell yeah, dude. Us autizzies, I told you, we rule the world. I told you, dude.
Man.
I wasn't joking. I said that multiple episodes again. We're fucking coming for you, normies.
Yeah, you said that like 10 episodes ago or something.
Yeah, and I don't keep track. All of them are kind of bleeding together along with my life. I don't remember what day is what anymore.
I feel like I'm going to go back and watch an old episode. Like, I don't remember saying any of this.
Oh, I can't wait until when someone tries to cancel me and they're like, they're going to pull up a transcript of something I said. I'm like, I never fucking said that. And then they pull up the video. I'm like, God damn it, I said that.
So true. It's
by God, I fucking definitely said that. Like
the whole point of this podcast is for us to just ramble what comes up in our heads. And nothing's usually in my head, so that's why I usually say nothing. That's why Locos introduce it.
Yeah, I mean, I'm just very highly intelligent. I hope you realize that. Someone recently told me I have a high IQ. He was dumb, though, so I don't know how well we should trust his opinion. Like, he was stupid. So I don't know if we should really take that as, like a high mark, but I'm just saying, did anyone tell you have a high IQ this week?
Nope. So
I think that means I'm at least a bit smarter, or that my friends are just way dumber than yours. You know what I'm saying, Evan?
Oh, yeah, I'm not intelligent.
I mean, I don't know, you have a degree, that's something, right?
Yeah,
you're able to figure out college. I mean, that's that you have some form of intelligence. Like, you're not a complete fucking idiot.
The fact that
like not complete, not saying not saying you can't.
I am a little bit.
Yeah, I mean, I'm not saying like if you go to college that you can't be an idiot. Like, there's a bunch of people who go to college that are still fucking morons, but you're not a complete idiot. Like, clearly, you know, you had to fucking write papers and shit. That takes some level of intellect. So good on you. Good on you.
I'm trying to think, when's the last time you've written the paper?
Well, I was writing a book. It's been on hiatus. I had writer's block, so I stopped about a month ago, but that's technically not a paper. Last time I wrote a paper. I'd have been 19 or 18. I don't know, it was my first semester after high school. So yeah, I turned 19 during that time. So yeah, it'd been like right when I turned 19, because I did the first semester of college after high school. So you know, 6 years, over 6 years, going on seven. 6 years going on seven. All right, but we got to do plugs.
Yeah,
we already fucking wrapped up. Oh, we'll do it real quick. I had to work late, but anyways, I went over to my mom's and I brought her Chinese food. We ate and then we hung out for a while. I got my mom and I got everyone Chinese food. It was just me, my mom, and my dad. I got us all Chinese food and we ate it and hung out. Pretty simple stuff. It wasn't even a story. All right, so vlogs. All right, if you're watching this on YouTube, make sure you smash the like button and crush the subscribe button. I want one of those horns there. You know that one? We need sound effects. We need to work on getting fucking sound effects. But yes, smash the like button, crush the subscribe button. Y'all didn't subscribe enough last episode, so guess what? No Jabberwocky dance. That's on you guys. Should have shared the podcast. Speaking of sharing the podcast, share the fucking podcast. We're doing this for free. We're at 32 fucking episodes. See, now it's 32 hours. You understand that? We've been doing this for 32 weeks. It's insane.
It is insane. It's more than half a year.
Over half a year. We've been giving you free content roughly an hour of content every week. No, you've never spent a dime on this. So fucking just share it. Do the three charity work and fucking be a good person and share it. If you're listening to this on Spotify, make sure you hit fucking follow. Download all the episodes. Actually, weirdly enough, our views on YouTube are down, but our audio's up. We got a fucking guy from Ho Chi Minh City that listened to us. Couple people from Ho Chi Minh City. We're growing a following in China.
We're going global.
Well, we already had Belgium, dude, and we've been getting sometimes Russians. I've been doing all right in the Middle East. We're getting popping up a little bit in the Middle East, but now Ho Chi Minh, what up, dude? Ho Chi Minh City, how you doing? Now that China's listened to us, that means we're not long away from being canceled or banned in China, which will be sick. I hope we get banned in China. You know how much that'd make my life if I was banned from China?
I don't know.
I would like
the views in the following.
Just me and Winnie the Pooh are unwanted posters.
You both only have your shirts on.
Yeah, both of us have the shirts on. We're no bottom hard.
Yeah.
Yeah, just straight fucking free dicking it. Also, if you're listening on Stitcher, do the same thing. Make sure you download all the episodes and hit follow. That is awesome. Follow us on our Facebook page at Inept Pit. Go ahead and hit like. We'll post all the new episodes up on there. And eventually, we're going to add some extra content once I get my fucking tax returns and stimulus.
It's so funny how you're just...
Once the government wants to give me my money. And what else? Oh, if you want to book us for something, you can contact us at netpit@gmail. You can ask us questions, concerns, or you can just book us for a live podcast or stand up. You can do one of us, both of us, all of us. You can do the whole crew. You can do the fucking live podcast and stand up, live podcast, just one or the other, or me, just me. You could just do me if you don't like Evan. You could just do me. That's totally cool too. In some world, weird world, if you just want Evan, that's cool too. Go ahead. You can contact him for stand up on there. And what else am I missing?
Leave a review.
Oh, yeah, Apple Podcasts. You'll see on Apple Podcasts. Make sure you leave a 5-star rating and write a little bit of a review. I don't care if it's positive or negative, your fucking review, as long as you leave one and the rating's 5. We want 5 stars. Don't care about your words. So your voice is meaningless to us. By the way, comment on the video. Comment on the video with what your favorite fucking artificial candy flavors are. And if you also think hot tamales and lemon heads are fucking bullshit, like I do.
Or tell us your favorite song by Three Doors Down.
It's
Or
kryptonite.
what you
It's
think.
kryptonite. That's not even a very. Everyone's just kryptonite.
Or what you think our band name would be if we started a band. What do you think
Yeah.
it'd be?
Also, fucking check out Great White Rhino on Bandcamp.
Yeah, definitely.
Oh, I have plugs. Evan, do your own Twitter while I pull up my shows.
You can follow me on Twitter at Salsa Evan. I'll be tweeting a lot of, stand up comedy, Saturday Night Live, whatever pops in my head, dumb jokes usually get like a couple likes or no likes. So you can be part of the fun. It's also
Oh,
on
yeah,
Twitter.
that's great, Evan. I was totally listening. Fantastic stuff. All right, so these are the shows that you're going to be able, because yeah, we're at Parrot's Lounge or on the 13th of May. I'll be at Parrot Lounge in Holland at 8 p.m. It's a fun room. On the 16th, I'll be at Mulligan's Pub in Grand Rapids, 8 p.m. Seven, I'll be doing 3 nights in a row. In Grand Rapids, 16th I'll be in Mulligan's Pub. 17th I'll be at Fulton Street Pub. Those shows are both at 8. Garage Bar at 7.
Are you just crashing there or are you coming back?
I don't know. I might crash
Okay.
if I find a place to crash. I got a couple friends out there I could maybe stay at. I ain't paying for a hotel, I'll tell you that much. Drew does not have the guap for that. 24th, I'll be at Crunchy's in Lansing at 8 p.m. And the 25th, I'll be at Tip Top Deluxe Bar in Grand Rapids at 8 p.m. A lot of Grand Rapids.
On Memorial Day, I'll be at Crunchy's 8 p.m. That's my next gig.
Awesome. Well, sick. That's been the podcast, guys. Thanks for listening. Suck our dicks, eat our butts. We'll see you on 33.
Peace. Thanks
Bye.
for listening.